and making sure that we stay in the middle of the road, making sure that we're dealing always with relativity. The Big Book does not deal with relativity. It deals with categorical imperatives. Either or. One of its favorite phrases is or else. And every time you see must or have to, it means or else. Doesn't mean it would be kind of nice if you sort of did it. And so resentments lead only to futility and unhappiness. To the precise extent that we permit these, please notice the word permit. It's very important to parse each sentence as you go in the Big Book. It's too dense to just skim it. The word permit puts the onus on us, doesn't it? It doesn't say that we are the unwitting victims of the wrongdoing of others, that we can do nothing about it. It says that we permit these.
You said when it says permit, it means that we allow it?
Yes, that's what permit means. It means we took no action. We went with it. Most of the time because we felt resentments were a wonderful thing because we were justified in how we felt. And after all, if I can resent you, then I'll have to look at myself. And if I can resent you and the things you've done, I've got great excuses for my own crapped out behavior. No wonder I did what I did. Look at what John did to me. To the precise extent that we permit these, do we squander the hours that might have been worthwhile? You see what the Big Book is telling us here, that these resentments have in fact taken our lives away from us. Each day that we permit these to remain, we are flushing it down the John, our days, our hours. But with the alcoholic, whose hope is the maintenance and growth of a spiritual experience, remember that when Bill wrote the Big Book, he used the term spiritual experience to encompass the entire panoply of spiritual experiences, or in other words, the results of working the steps. And when he first wrote the 12th step, he wrote having had a spiritual experience as a result of these steps. It was only after the editorial board got hold of it that that was changed to spiritual awakening. So what you're looking at here, the alcoholic whose hope is the maintenance and growth of a spiritual experience can read that as spiritual awakening if it will help. This business of resentment is infinitely grave. How much more grave can you get than infinite gravity? We found that it is fatal. Aha, that's why it's infinitely grave. How can this be? How is it that our resentments of others can kill us? The answer, for when harboring such feelings, we shut ourselves off from the sunlight of the Spirit. The insanity of alcohol returns and we drink again. And with us, to drink is to die. This is the same basic fundamental maxim that we've been dealing with all along. We're powerless over alcohol, that alcoholism is a fatal, incurable, progressive illness, that our only hope of recovery is to get a loving God between us and the booze. If we are therefore blocked off from the sunlight of the Spirit, blocked off from God, we will drink again. The insanity of alcohol returns, and we drink again. And for us, to drink is to die. You see the synergism here, how it all comes together? Now it's becoming real clear that we're going to have to do whatever it takes to be set free from our resentments. And in the future, when resentments come up, take whatever measures are necessary to be freed from them. Resentments are like a cancer. One of the things you as sponsors need to remember is that any resentment which is left over, it's kind of like saying to the surgeon, you can take all the cancer out of my bladder, but just leave a few specks in there. Be kind of interested to see if it grows again. Now, nobody in their right mind would do that. And so we're going to make every effort to see to it that each and all of the resentments that this person came in the door with are taken from them. And we have the spiritual solution here in the big book to do that.